Welcome to Mastering Solutions. This is a projectile motion problem where they tell us that a gray kangaroo can bound across a flat stretch of ground with each jump carrying it 10 meters from the takeoff point. If the kangaroo leaves the ground at 20 degrees, what are the takeoff speed and the horizontal speed? So if we draw an arc here, this represents the kangaroo's jump, and this distance is 10 meters. This jump right here is 20 degrees. So we'll draw a velocity vector to represent the initial velocity. And this angle from the ground, they say, is 20 degrees. Let's redraw this triangle right here. So we have the initial velocity. That's one of the first things that we need to solve for, the takeoff speed. But we also need to figure out what is the x component of that velocity. That's the second thing that we have to solve for. So obviously we have a right triangle with the x and the y components. And so we'll come back to this in a moment. But before we get into it, there's several ways that you can approach this problem. The book decided to do a much longer way that involves more substitution. If you want me to explain how they approached it, I'm happy to make a follow-up video, but I'm assuming most people just want the shorter, easier method to get to the answer. So for the first part, what we're going to use is the range equation. This is given in the book. The range equation is equal to v squared times the sine of 2 theta divided by g. So the range in this case will be the 10 meters. We want to solve for velocity, so let's rearrange this for v. So we'll first multiply both sides of the equation by g. So now we have g times r is equal to v squared sine 2 theta, and then we'll divide both sides by sine 2 theta. So now we have v squared is equal to g times r divided by sine of 2 theta. We'll take the square root of both sides, and now we have v, or the velocity right here, the takeoff speed, is equal to the square root of gr divided by sine of 2 theta. So gravity will of course be a negative 9.8 meters per second squared. The range is 10 meters. We'll divide that by sine of 2 times 20 degrees. So we have the square root of negative 9.8 times 10 divided by sine of 2 times 20. But now just looking at this, one problem that this would give us is since we have a negative in here, we can't take the square root of a negative value. The calculator will give you an error domain. So what we need to do is just use positive g, and then this will now give us the correct answer. So we have the square root of 9.8 times 10 divided by sine of 2 times the degree 20, which gives us 12.34, so we'll round that to 12.3 meters per second, is the answer for the takeoff speed for the kangaroo. Now we can take this velocity and come back up here and plug it into our triangle that we made. Now we have the hypotenuse of our right triangle, and we want the adjacent to the angle, so we'll use cosine. So let's give us some space, and now we'll write that. So since we want this right here, we'll use cosine. So cosine of the angle theta is equal to adjacent over the hypotenuse. We want to solve for adjacent, so we'll multiply both sides by h. So adjacent is equal to h cosine of theta. And the adjacent in this case is the initial velocity in the x direction, so the x component of the initial velocity. And the hypotenuse is 12.3 meters per second. We'll times it by the cosine of theta, which we said is 20 degrees. So 12.3 times the cosine of 20 gives us 11.5, so 11.6. We could round that to 12, so 11.6, which is 12 meters per second, is the x component for the kangaroo. So it's mostly x component. The y component isn't that much. It's mostly jumping in the horizontal direction. And like I said, if you want me to go through the longer route to get to these, let me know. I'm happy to make a follow-up video, so comment below if you want that. Otherwise, here are your answers: 12.3 meters per second for the takeoff speed, and 11.6, or rounded to 12 meters per second, for the x component of the takeoff speed.